What's up, Ham Boys? It's Timmy Joe. We're here in my garage, finally back in the garage in the summertime doing some fun stuff. You did a lot of stuff last year when I was like, you know, doing other things, but it's computer focused now, so we are going to be doing a little project concerning a test bench. I don't have a test bench and they cost a lot of money. I figured I could just make one, so I went down to this place. I mean, what the hell is going on there? That place has been in business, for like a million years in my town, and it's always looked like that. So I got this case for $10. Awesome deal considering it is, you know, a state-of-the-art Tegger case. Came with free CD-ROM, and check this out, boys. Free Windows XP key right here. So, I'm going to be de-riveting this thing and figuring out a way to place a motherboard in it quickly. Nothing too fancy, but I need something I can fire a motherboard in, do some testing, maybe permanently keep a little computer in there for swapping out video cards and whatnot. I want to make it so it's got some cooling, and I'm going to use this little power supply I got from FSP, which is going to be pretty cool. But stay tuned, we're going to cue an intro, and we're going to figure out how to turn an old computer case into a test bench. For service on your Tegger computer, please contact Timmy Joe. So, probably gonna do something along the lines of removing these cages. I'm gonna keep, you know, this whole thing intact. See if I can't easily get this top piece off and maybe cut the sides out. I'm not sure. This looks like this top piece could just, oh yeah. Top piece, come off, you bastard. Gotta take this piece off, but yeah. We're gonna whittle her down to our bare bones, and then I wanna just make it so that the power supply usually goes underneath in the test bench. I'm gonna keep it right where it is now. And, oh, see, this is all, that comes right apart already. I'll do some stuff, so stay tuned. Disconnect telephone lines before removing this cover. Okay, so this is already looking pretty good. I think we're gonna go ahead and start removing a few rivets. I'm also gonna maybe use the feet from this to prop up the bottom of it so that, you know, it's propped up like this. You can fire some motherboards in there. We'll put this little tiny PSU in there too from FSP. I mean, look how tiny this thing is. But it has a bracket so you can put it in kind of any normal spot, and then, you know, that way it'll make it, it's out of the way, it's fully modular, you only need the pieces that, you know, are going to connect to the motherboard. So, it's exactly what I wanted. Now, I'm gonna do something to secure the sides, make some sort of a connecting rail. I have my own rivet gun, so figure something out here. Maybe we can use this on the bottom somehow too. So, lots of options here, but it's gonna be fun. it's Timmy Joe. We finished off our little project here, at least for the foreseeable future. I have a lot more to do on it, but I wanted to kind of show you how you can accomplish, you know, some sort of a test bench just using an old $10 computer case you find at your local junkyard. Anyways, I got my little tiny micro ATX Dagger power supply in here. It's fully modular. Got some drive cages so we can put, you know, SSDs. We'll lock them down maybe, you know, but this is just, you know, some old parts I had lying around to kind of show you the form over function. But yeah, she looks pretty nice. I used the original feet from the computer. I just kind of riveted the bottom panel, split it in half, made it work, made these side rails. It's pretty good. So that is the test bench. I want to paint it. I need to embed the switches into it, make it so that, you know, it's a little bit more functional. But the next time you see it, it should look a lot better. And yeah, just wanted to show you how far I got, kind of a part one. But yeah, fully functional test bed out of an old computer case. All you need to do is remove some rivets, have a little forethought, make sure maybe you have a Sawzall that'll, you know, cut up the pieces, a pair of tin snips. But an old computer case like this, the tin is really easy to work with. So I'm at WatchTimmyJoe on Instagram and Twitter. That's my test bench for the foreseeable future. And I thank you very much for sticking around watching, and let me know if I'm absolutely crazy. But I think this turned out very well. I didn't really lock too much in here. But you guys have a nice day. Thanks for watching.